Hi, this is Grant with BirdX, and we'll be walking through the Solar Yard Gard Ultrasonic Pest Animal Repeller. First, we're going to go over some of the controls on the device, with that being the frequency dial. As you can see here on the right, there is a low setting, medium, high, and then low plus, medium plus, and high plus. This is a range from 15 to 20 kilohertz. So the low is 15 kilohertz, medium is 20, high is 25. And the plus indicates that there's going to be a flashing light when the device is turned on or activated. On the left, you can see the sensitivity dial. This changes the sensitivity of the motion sensor here on the front. Now let's see how that operates. So we have the device with the sensitivity setting pretty low since we're very close to it. But as you can see, as I move my hand past the motion sensor, the blue light is going to turn on and the sounds are emitted. Now, if I were to switch it over to the plus setting, you will see the light operate like this. So I want to discuss just a few differences between the Solar Yard Gard and the standard yard guard. The first of that being that, again, there is this light here that the standard yard guard does not have. It is solar powered, which has the panel up here that charges the AA rechargeable batteries that come with the device. And if you ever have any days of extended cloudiness and need to charge the device, there is a little port down here that allows you to use a USB charger that plugs right in, charge the device overnight, and it'll be good to go in the morning. The Solar Yard Gard also comes with a stake that goes into the bottom of the device, allowing you to easily mount it in the ground or in something like a flower pot. So you can see on the bottom here, and here's a stake, and it's going to slide right in. So now just a few best practices and tips. Again, positioning the speaker as close to the problem area as you can is always best. You want the speaker facing in the direction of the main problem area. Physical obstructions will diminish the effectiveness of the device, as with all ultrasonics. And you want to avoid tilting the speaker up, as that may allow water to seep into the speaker port, causing damage. Again, the lower the frequency, the more effective ultrasonic devices are going to be for all animal types, as they're going to travel further and be heard more by the animals. Another thing for the Solar Yard Gard specifically is to keep an eye on which sensitivity setting is going to be best. Occasionally, moving foliage may trip the motion sensor, causing the device to operate more frequently than you would like. So it's something you want to test out and see what works best. If you have any additional questions, please do give us a call here at BirdX, and we're happy to help. Thank you again for checking in on the Solar Yard Gard.